Okay, let's keep this possession simple. Hey, Hickson, come set this screen, man. Come on. Let's do this. Nice pick and roll. Oh, ankle breaker. Hold on. I'm going to the rack. Oh, hold on. Tayshaun, you good? Yeah, what's up with that foul, man? You doing the wrong thing at the wrong time, baby. I'm out here celebrating on y'all. What's up? After finally taking the starting point guard position from Damian Lillard, my boy Batum came back from injury, so I'm loving the way our lineup is going. And in this game, I even got player of the game. I was doing my thing out there being a facilitator, but check this out.
15 total assists for you. You could say this was a statement game for you with how you passed the ball. Do you see this performance changing how teams play against you?
I'm not really sure if it will or it won't. That's really in their hands. If they do find a way to adjust, though, I'll just have to counteract that with some tweaks of my own. Each team will try and come at you a different way with a different look, and it'll be a bit of a challenge. But I know if I keep working hard and just playing my game, I'll find ways to help this team get to where we need to be.
Check me out. I was even getting professional on that thing. I was letting everybody know that I'm here to stay. You can check out how many games I got completed, and this is where things got iffy. I decided, you know what, I got the starting position at the point guard spot, and I decided to finally start key gaming it. Now let me show you what happens when you key game in the NBA 2K13. You guys are going to be pissed.
It's a Western Conference battle here at the Staples Center in downtown Los Angeles as the Lakers look to work home court advantage. Blazers coming to town hoping to notch one here in this one game road trip. And of course, they're looking forward to the return of Dwight Howard.
Kevin, it looks like he should make a welcome return after being hurt a few weeks back.
And nobody's going to be more happy about it than he is, I assure you. He's dying to get back out onto the court.
The starters for the Portland Trail Blazers.
Yo, what's going on, everybody? It's iPodKingCarter here, the Superman of YouTube. And in this commentary, I got a little bit of explaining to do. Now, I know you guys seen the pregame rituals, you guys seen the starting lineup, and you saw that I wasn't in it. You guys saw that Damian Lillard took his spot back from me, and I know a couple people were thinking, is iPod injured? And then you see me in the pregame rituals, and you're like, why is iPod not a starter? Well, let me kind of give you guys a clear picture of what I'm trying to think here. When you key game this game and you are not at the right level, the right respectability, have the right abilities, or don't have a good overall or overall play style, you will get bumped back down to the bench. Your coach will not keep the minutes that you have acquired with all your hard work and to key game it like a pussy. That's basically what I'm saying to you guys. So the coach basically said, you know what, you want to key game it? I got a little trick for you. Why don't we put you back to the bench and put the better guard in at the point guard position? So I couldn't be mad. You know, At first, what I did was I quit the game as soon as I didn't see me in the starting lineup because I thought I got injured. And then I went into my minutes in rotation. I said, wow, they bumped me back down to 23 minutes. I'm back to the sixth man. And all I did was key game about 15 or 20 games. And I was like, you know what? Guess what? I can't key game it anymore. If I key game it, that means that I have to be at least four games away from a key game in order to key game it. I'm not going to key game any more 2 week periods or months. What I'm going to actually do is I'm going to play like a certain amount of games within a month, and then I'm going to just key game it. Hopefully, I'll be able to win an award or something, you know, like player of the week. Maybe. I don't know. But as of right now, all I can say is Kobe, he just did me dirty right there. Check that out. That's vintage Kobe right there, man. Let's get into halftime, y'all.
Presented by Sprint.
Hello, everyone. I'm Damon Bruce, and the NBA season is really getting into gear. Portland with the lead against the Lakers. As far as the conference is concerned, they're sitting right in the leader's rearview mirror. Well, LaMarcus Aldridge is making it look easy against the Lakers. He's up to 14 points, been getting to the rim, been getting to the line, and a great shooting percentage from both. There's no quitting the Lakers. They came to win. They're really going hard at it on the boards, offensively chasing down every miss they can. Kobe Bryant, huge impact. He's picked up 22 points and is always looking to go to work on the boards. Thanks for being with us. Now back to Los Angeles as the third quarter gets underway.
Welcome back to Staples Center, and above it, downtown Los Angeles in the distance.
Well, how about Kobe in this?
Okay, now that we're back to the regular scheduled programming, I wanted to give you guys a few tips on how you can stop this from happening in your My Career. Now, the first thing that you want to do is, any person that you're battling a position for, you want to make sure that every attribute that you have and they have, make sure you're at least 3 points above theirs. The next thing you want to do is your offensive and defensive awareness. I want you guys to max that out first so that you can have a high overall so that the coach can look at you as a person that they're interested in keeping opposed to somebody else. And the next thing that I want you to do is go to the GM's office. Go to the GM and say, hey, I'm having a problem with a certain player, and get that player booted or get him minimal minutes. And that stuff right there will be the best thing that would ever happen to you guys, I promise you. Now, I want to talk about this play that just happened. I left somebody at the half court line. We about to run it back. Yes, I got the cam on him. It's about to go down. Look at that crossover. Boy, if you don't get up off your ass. Nah, but the gameplay, I definitely like this gameplay because it's not so much. You know, I got 8 points, 8 assists currently, but I'm doing anything I can to get my double-double. You guys know, when I play a game as a point guard, it's mandatory for you to get 10 assists. And as a scorer, in my mind, it's mandatory for me to get at least 10 points. So right now I have 10 and 8. I'm going to the rack. And you see I'm looking for the assists, but they passing the ball out, giving me great team ball movement. But the only thing on my mind is I got to shoot the J with 5 seconds left on the clock. You see it's Kevin Durant, J. Look inside the description. If you want to know anything about my player, it should be in the description. If it's not in the description, let me know, and I will put it inside the descriptions. Also, one thing I wanted to address about the way I make my videos. A lot of people have been telling me, hey man, take out the pregame intros, take out the halftime report, take out the spray uncontainable game, and all of this nonsense. This is the way I make my videos. And the reason why I make my videos like this is because not too many people make their videos quite like mine. So I like to try to be unique because that's what you guys come to my channel for. You don't come to my channel for me to be like somebody else. And I totally understand that. But some people just don't understand that when you seem like another commentator and they think that that other commentator is better, why do you think they should watch your videos if you don't have anything unique to bring to the table? So with that being said, I'm going to keep making my videos the way I make them. I would love to think that they come out looking good. From the feedback that I get in the comment section, they seem to come out looking good. So I'm definitely loving all the feedback that I've been getting. I definitely take a lot of things in consideration. Even if it's trolling, if you guys are just trolling me just to troll me, I still look at myself in the mirror and say, hey, you know what? That's a good thing to think about. Maybe I'll use that in my next video and see how people will like it, not just that one individual person. So with that being said, this commentary is coming to an end. I know I don't usually say that, but this commentary isn't much live as my usual commentaries, you know, but I just wanted to get a couple things off to you guys, give you guys a few tips. But this is IKC signing out. I'm going to let Jive Turkey 215 take it from here, y'all. Peace.
Greg Oden didn't pan out, so they drafted iPod. David Carter, perfect picture like a tripod. A point guard that delivers like Papa John's. Me drafted as the front page topic, I'm Philly's pride, Team Villanova. Finesse game, but the heart of a soldier. When I go to the rack, there's no stopping me. Better bring a double team, better stand properly. On defense, move your feet. Taking the blaze to the chip to abuse the heat. I was raised like a crip cause I ruled the street. Not the court, the blacktop, the moves, the heat. Pull off, it's like the late, great, great Magic Johnson. I got drafted 11th, that was nonsense. Name a player that penetrates better. Number 15 on the polo sports sweater. Chris Paul better pass the torch fast. I'm the weatherman on the court, the forecast. Said it's gon' rain, I'ma bring pain. Double team Dave Carter, bet I go lame. I'm the king, LeBron better step off. He kicked the door down, I'll blow the deck off. No rookie in this league can get with me. Most points, most assists, better make history. History, history.
Congratulations on the win tonight. It was definitely a nail biter. How are you feeling after a close game like that?
Well, I'm feeling as though that I should be in a starting position, and I feel as though it wouldn't have been a close game if I started, but who knows?
Woo! That game was a testament to these guys around me. We really came together as a team and did what we had to do to stay on top. This is the kind of game that really makes you proud to be a part of a group like this. I can't say enough about the job everyone did. Team morale is definitely on the rise after a win like that. Woo!
Man, I tell you guys, my man is so professional. He keep it 100 in the press conference, man. I'm just trying to get my fans and my teammate chemistry up. All right, y'all. Thanks for rocking with me. Peace.